On July 20th, 1969, humanity landed on the moon for the very first time.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
This set the stage for what would be an age of inspiration, building towards the stars and everything beyond it. But it's already 2022, and the lingering question has been, why haven't we gone back yet? Now, over 50 years later, we're headed back to the moon, and once again looking further beyond. Welcome to the Modern Day Geeks, and in this video, we'll be talking about NASA's Artemis program. Artemis is NASA's project to return humans to the moon by 2025. It's been a long time coming, and it will light the way for future expeditions to the moon and ultimately to Mars. The Artemis program, named after the Greek goddess of the hunt, is the modern equivalent of the Apollo mission back in the 60s and 70s. But whereas Apollo's aim was short-term lunar exploration, Artemis was made to support a long-term human presence on and around the moon. Through Artemis, NASA's aim is to land the first woman and first person of color on the moon, lighting the way in a new era for space exploration. This mission, while led by NASA, is also carried forward with the Artemis Accords, an international agreement that establishes a set of provisions for the sustainable human exploration of the moon and the other celestial bodies. As of October 2021, the Artemis Accords have garnered the signature of 13 countries, with it being open for signature indefinitely, as NASA anticipates many other nations joining sometime in the future. It all starts with companies delivering scientific instruments and technology demonstrations to the lunar surface, followed by a lunar orbiter called Gateway, NASA's space station orbiting the moon that's planned to act as a staging area for future moon missions and everything afterwards. A lunar station has been planned for decades, actually going by several names such as Deep Space Habitat and Lunar Orbital Platform Gateway, before simply being called Gateway. With all that said, our return to the moon takes off with Artemis 1. Launching from the Kennedy Space Station in Florida, Artemis 1 is just the first in a series of intricate missions. It'll be the maiden launch and crucial flight test of the Space Launch System, or SLS, NASA's most powerful rocket yet. Sat comfortably on top of it is the ORION spacecraft, which will serve as the main exploration vehicle that will carry astronauts into space and sustain them for the entire journey to and from the moon. For this specific mission, however, the ORION will be uncrewed. With its unprecedented power and capabilities, SLS is the only rocket right now that is capable of sending the Orion, the astronauts, and cargo to the moon in a single mission. It surpasses even the incredible Saturn V rocket that propelled the Apollo missions back then, which is just insane. Traveling 280,000 miles from Earth, the Orion capsule will make history for venturing further than any other human spacecraft has ever gone. As of December 2021, the mission has been pushed to around March 2022, more or less. Next in line is Artemis 2, and this is incredible because it's going to be the first scheduled crewed mission for the Orion spacecraft. With confidence gained from the Artemis 1 mission and the amount of hours put into prior flight and ground testing, it's now time for the crew of the Artemis 2 to launch aboard the Orion for what is approximately a 10-day mission. It's on this trip that the crew will perform a lunar flyby, while at the same time setting a record for the farthest human travel, roughly 40,000 miles beyond the far side of the moon before returning home. Even though Artemis 2 will be the first crewed mission to visit the moon's vicinity in more than 50 years, that crew will not land just yet. That's reserved for Artemis 3. There haven't been a lot of details about what is arguably the biggest mission of the Artemis program, but let us introduce you to it anyway. Artemis 3 is the second crewed mission of the whole program, and the first to land astronauts on the moon. The crew will visit the moon's south pole to search for water, study its surface, test technologies, and learn to work on a world outside Earth. The Orion spacecraft will dock at the aforementioned Gateway Lunar Station before heading down to the surface of the Moon via a human lander, where they will contain a plethora of samples intended to deepen our understanding of the Moon. Artemis 3 is now scheduled to take place no earlier than 2025. So after all this, what happens next for NASA and the Artemis program? With the invaluable knowledge gained from these three massive missions to the Moon, all eyes are set on sending humans all the way to Mars. Now, NASA is continuing to work with a number of companies to address the huge challenges of living in space. For your information, missions to the Moon are about 1,000 times farther than any mission to the International Space Station orbiting the Earth as we speak. So you can imagine how much more challenging it'll be to create systems that are not only light enough to operate far from home while supporting human life, but also keeping it light enough to launch. The Artemis missions will serve as a unique opportunity to test and perfect many of the technologies and complex operations needed for human exploration of Mars as early as the 2030s. That's pretty much it. Did you enjoy the video? Let us know your thoughts and if you're excited for what's next for humanity in space moving forward. Leave us a like and subscribe while you're here.